they need money. For them to live in the countryside. So my idea is is expected to be a very important law for the biofuel. So my idea is along the road, plants of jatropha in your country, and people, and walking, many people walking along the road. So people take take it and put it in the point. Every 2 kilometers, every 3 kilometers point. And someone comes there and gathers the jatropha and produce fuel. And then they save. So the community can get money. So that's what I'm planning to do. So maybe I'm applying for a federal budget, but at this stage when I have not received any budget. But if I could get budget, I want to work on this project in Nepal. So the people can remain and can stay in the countryside, and also they can get money. And also, with the high technology, the people can run the vehicle, very, very eco-friendly vehicles in the countryside. So people remain in the countryside, and so the infrastructure in the urban area is not so much high. Why? Because last night we are coming back from Pokhara by bus, and we are reached to the entrance of Kathmandu around 5 o'clock. But we could reach to the hotel around 7:30 or something, 2 hours, because of the traffic jam. So maybe the situation is not bad to worse now. But if we work on this project, so people remain in the countryside. So that's my ideas. And also this is the case of Malaysia. Palm oil, and this is rainforest. So in Malaysia, I'm also conducting my research in Malaysia. And in Malaysia, this is a palm oil, and this is rainforest. And rainforest cutting down, because rainforest to make a land. And then after that, it's also afforestation, it's kind of palm tree is planted. And then the plant lorry comes to the countryside and gather the palm oil. And it seems as to be sustainable. But the problem is the palm oil trees can only survive only 20 or 30 years. And the palm oil tree were exhausted. Spend much nutrition in the land. So after the 20 or 30 years later, we have to abandon the land. So we have to cut the palm trees. So this is that, after cutting down the palm tree. So I don't think this scenario is sustainable. So maybe we also should know about the examples in the world, and we try to find the sustainable way in Nepal. So that's my presentation. And then next, I will let my students to give a talk. And then, if we still have time, I'll give a talk. So maybe, if we do have time, and by the way, let's see. Next speaker, this is in Japanese, but maybe you will know, you can imagine his research. Maybe he will give a talk, maybe 10 minutes or something.
10 minutes. Namaste. Very nice to meet you. So my name is Yuji Inada. So I'm a graduate student. He's my professor. So, next to the. So my my research is biofuel in Japan. So Sanda city is a typical city in Japan. So in this research, I use GIS. Do you know GIS?
Yes.
Already? Okay, next question. research this area. So Sanda City, Sasayama City, and Tamba City. So my university is in around here, just here. So my research abstract is in Japan. So gasoline. Fossil fuel is also very expensive. Japan should change the fuel, fossil fuels to fuel, because so too much cost. And a very big problem is global warming. So it's a very big problem. So I think the very source of the source is the ethanol. So do you know this? Thank you.